door Sunday, about 12 o'clock. Knock on the door, and the fucker was never in. You could see him coming through the glass pane, coming down the stairs in his pants. Really cheap pants. His hair be fucking everywhere. He'd be picking his nose or picking his arse or something when he was in the door. And then he'd invite me in, walk me through to the kitchen, the cornerstone of every nutritious Welsh breakfast, bag of salt and vinegar and ribs. And then his mother would quiz me, what time did I come home last night? I'd say about 12, maybe. Well, why isn't he getting a fucking 3 o'clock? And oh my God, his mother's name was Mabel. Now, the odds of a woman called Mabel finding a guy called Arthur Cable. So we were going to call the band Mabel Cable for a bit. We thought it was a bit like Lynyrd Skynyrd. So then fast forward to 2003, and we're opening up the biggest rock and roll band in the world, the Rolling Stones. Stade de France, 80,000 people. So we arranged to meet in the lobby at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. I walked downstairs. To my surprise, Stuart is still in the fucking bar from the night before. He's in the bar. No, he didn't do that when we played the Ivy Bush back home. I mean, it's a big gig. So after a very tense taxi ride to the stadium, we have a debate in the Rolling Stones catering department, which I might add, they had ice sculptures. At that time, all we had was crisps. So we settled our differences. We went on and we did a great show. We even had the Rolling Stones daughters flashing their knickers at us on the side of the stage. And they're on soup bottles now. We were way ahead of the fucking curve. After the gig, I found myself in Keith Richards' dressing room. Now in Keith Richards' dressing room, he's got a 12-foot snooker table, as much drink as he could possibly want. I mean, it's Keith Richards. And a shepherd's pie.